Hi, we are Zach and Jody Gray, and we are now going to cover the steps of getting custom white balance in your camera using the ExpoDisc.
Yeah, and we highly recommend that you guys watch all 5 of the different videos that we put together, because that's going to help you to learn how to use it in any given lighting situation and maximize the results that you're going to get out of the ExpoDisc.
Now we're going to go through the steps of getting custom white balance right in your camera. So we are going to have Meredith, our model, come on up.
Thank you.
So step number 1 is, in our camera, we want to make sure that it's set to custom white balance. So make sure that you're in your manual and checking that out so you know how to do it for your camera body. Step number 2 is, you are going to stand where your subject will be standing. So we kind of scoped out the area and we know that we want to shoot Meredith right here. I'm going to be standing over there where the camera is, shooting this way. So what we want to do is we want to stand where our subject is or is going to be. Sometimes we'll do this before they come on over. And we're going to put the ExpoDisc over our lens and point it where we're going to be shooting from. The next thing that we need to do, step 3, is we need to get a good exposure. So make sure that you check the following video where we talk about how to get an exposure with the ExpoDisc. So make sure to watch that. But once we have our correct exposure, now we are going to simply take a shot. And the thing to remember when you take a shot is, unless you're using back button focus with camera, you're gonna try and take a shot with the ExpoDisc over the lens and it's gonna be like, it's gonna be making some really hard noises because it's not going to be able to focus. So what you simply do is you can switch your camera's focus to manual focus, take the shot, and then simply just make sure you put it back to autofocus. The next step is, you want to double check and make sure that that exposure that you just took is correct. So you're going to look at the back of your camera and look at your histogram. If you see the spike down the middle or close to the middle, you know that you're in that sweet spot of that you want to be. The next thing of what you're going to do is, you're actually going to apply that color in your camera. From Canon to Nikon users, the process varies, so make sure that you check your manual on how to apply that custom color right in your camera. So go ahead and check that out, and then now you are ready to shoot your subject and you will get great color right inside your camera. The question often comes up, how often do I need to grab a new white balance? And the answer is, anytime the light changes. And it really doesn't take that long. Once you get in the habit of doing it, it takes only a few seconds. So I'm going to demonstrate how fast it can actually go. So we'll have Meredith come on up, and we're going to shoot her right here. So I stand in this area, I point it towards where I'm going to be shooting from, I adjust my camera settings so I have a down the line exposure, take the shot. Now I'm going to go ahead and walk and shoot our subject. Super nice.
Love it.
Meredith, you're awesome.